Hey all, welcome back to another video. So this is Lauren. That was her previous set that we did about 3 weeks ago. And she's coming in for a infill slash redesign, kind of. So this is me just filing her nails. I've sped this part up, so it looks rougher than it is. I'm using my bullet just to kind of whiz through this. The baby finger, the pointer and the thumb, I'm just taking the top coat off. And these two, we're going to change up a little bit. So I'm debulking and just taking it down thin. So I then infill her nails with cherry blossom, and on her ring finger I just apply a thin layer of clear acrylic, just because I'm going to add some glitters. I then remembered that I took the middle finger down, but then it wasn't that finger that I was going to put a little design on, it was the pointer finger, so I just put full cherry blossom over that now. So then back to the ring finger, I'm just applying glitters from Glitter Planet. Well, not glitters, a glitter from Glitter Planet. This is Reflex. Definitely one of my favourites, if not my favourite of all time from their... Well, I can't say that because I haven't really tried them all yet, but this is my favourite one so far. It's just the perfect glitter, the perfect colours. You need it in your collection, you really do. And then I cap in crystal glass. So onto the pointer finger. This is what we was going to put on the middle finger, but decided to go. Goodness, my, I really struggle with these voiceovers. I slur my words on a regular, just in general. That's just who I am, and I still try and I still do it on the voiceover, and I'm really trying. So yeah, trying to do this S shape that everybody's loving, with that same glitter that we used on the ring finger. Then I cap that hole now in clear acrylic, and then I also cap the middle finger in clear acrylic because I kept it thin because I thought we was going to do the design on that one, but we decided to do it on the pointer one, so I have to go back and thicken it up a little bit, put my apex in place, make sure it's nice and strong. So I'm just doing the same on the other hand, so I'll whisk through this part for you. So then I'm just going over her nails with my Efile. I kind of just try it, well, I try to just concentrate on the cuticle area just to get it nice and flush, because there was a little something on there. I was just trying to get it off. Just to smooth them out, make sure that there's no, like, nothing's lifting up or anything. I want it as smooth and as flush as I can. So I think the best way for me to do that, for me personally, is going with my Efile around that cuticle area. I then do come in with my hand file and just perfect the shape, and I go over the top with them again like this, just with my hand file, I always do. And then I buff her nails nice and smooth, and then she'll go and wash her hands, and we're ready for top coat and crystals. And I'm applying my crystals. I just put these straight onto the acrylic. I don't top coat first, I top coat after. It's just the best way for me for them to stay on, I think. So I'm using CJP's gripper glue and my crystal crayon. If anyone's new to this, they're not going to know what I'm talking about, are they? And I'm just applying crystals kind of down the nail. So I'm applying CJP's No Wipe Top Coat. I think that's what it's called. I haven't used it for so long, I forgot what it's called. I think it's No Wipe Top Coat. I'm just applying that thinly to all the nails and curing in my lamp for 60 seconds. On the other hand, when I filed her nails around her cuticle area on the glitter finger, on her ring finger, I kind of filed away part of the glitter. So what I just do if with something like that, I'll just apply my top coat, and then with a brush, usually my size 12 brush or my size 2 brush, don't really care, I then dip into the glitter, but I just go around the edges of the glitter just to get the fine glitter. I don't want no chunky glitter because they're not going to lay flat. I just want the little tiniest parts of the glitter in the multi-mix, and just apply those around the cuticle area. You'll see me do it just to cover that spare space, that clear space that I've filed away. So yeah, that was me doing that, and then I applied cuticle oil, gave it a little massage, making sure I never go over the nails with them because it just ruins the shine, and it really annoys me, especially on gel polish. Like, if you've just laid gel polish down, apply a cute coil and rub it down the nail, big mistake. So yeah, that's the set complete. I do hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up, and if you don't subscribe to my channel already, please do, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.